Hey guys, we're the Collinges, and today we're going to share some really exciting news with you.
Really exciting news about our channel.
We wanted to just sit down and have kind of a little casual chat with you after a lot of thinking about it, praying about it, brainstorming about it. We've made the decision to change our channel name. So Hey Collinges really started out as our email address. And when we started our YouTube channel, it kind of just rolled over. That was our email. That's what became our name. We never really gave it much thought because originally our YouTube was just to kind of share little pieces of our life with like family and friends. Collinge is our last name. Everyone says it wrong.
It's always a joke in our family. We guess, oh, how are they going to missay it this time?
When we really got serious about vlogging, we did talk about changing our name. We couldn't really decide what we would change it to. The kids really liked Hey Collinges, and so we just stayed with it.
It was our Instagram account as well, and so that kind of, we kind of just said, ah, we'll just stick with it. It's our last name. That's what people that are close to us know us by, so.
As we've gotten more serious about our vlog, and we've really dialed in into our why, it became clear that we wanted something that was more representative of our mission. Yes, we're a family vlog, but there's a deeper purpose behind why we're opening our lives and why we're sharing our journey with you guys. So we wanted our channel name to really represent that.
So when we decided to make our accounts public, it really came from a place of wanting to advocate for Estelle and for everybody with Down syndrome.
We've kind of embraced this family advocacy role, and that's really important to us. Sometimes people question why we're doing this. Why do you feel the need to like focus so much on Down syndrome? Why do you feel the need to advocate?
We really want people to see that having a baby like Estelle, having a child like Estelle, is absolutely not a burden.
Recently, I had a video pop up as a suggested video in my YouTube feed, and it was about a prenatal diagnosis, and I was reading the comments, and there was one comment that just struck me. It was like a thread of comments because somebody said, if we would have gotten a prenatal diagnosis, we would have definitely terminated. Mm-hmm. And they said, that would be a life ruiner. And all the comments underneath that one were in agreement. Mm-hmm. Totally. We couldn't handle it. That's just not something that we would do. It would ruin our life, is the consensus. That's still out there. That's still a very real thought process that goes on. We're just hoping to provide an alternative narrative than the one that society's pushing right now.
Absolutely. Yeah, we want people to have a firsthand view into our lives. Our life is crazy. We're all over the place. We're all mixed up,
But it was crazy before Down syndrome.
It would be the same way with or without Estelle, and that's the thing that people need to see.
There are still a lot of ignorances, a lot of stereotypes, and we're just hoping that sharing our life and showing people that, you know, Estelle's a normal little kid. Our journey with Down syndrome is certainly not everyone's journey with Down syndrome, but I think that's kind of the point in sharing it, is just giving a glimpse into what our life looks like. And we have a child with Down syndrome, and showing that just as it is in any family, our life looks different than anyone else's. So just showing that like Down syndrome isn't the thing that defines us, but we're living our normal life with Down syndrome.
Absolutely. It's challenging, but it's also so exciting and so fun and so rewarding.
There was a moment at the beginning, I really would wonder, like, what is our life gonna look like? Yeah. Will we ever be able to do fun stuff again? Or will she hinder us because of her diagnosis? Now, that wasn't something I fixated on, but that was something that would creep in every once in a while, were these doubts and these fears. And during that time, I would always feel this word kind of come into my heart, and that word was extra. You know, people with Down syndrome have an extra chromosome, but that was the word that my heart would fixate on in the middle of my fears. I just felt like every time I would start to spiral down the negative thoughts and the fears, like God would just place that word on my heart. Like he would just whisper it in my ear. Almost audibly, I would hear that word extra. And that would just kind of settle my soul and be like, okay, life is gonna be okay. Life with Down syndrome is gonna be more than, not less than. Mm-hmm. And so that word through everything in our journey so far has kind of been the word that I've fixated on.
So with all that said, we are officially changing our name from Hey Collinges to
The Extra Fam. So we brainstormed about so many things, but the word extra just kept coming to us. It kept coming to us. And when we came up with The Extra Fam, everyone got really excited. So we hope you guys love it as much as we do. This name is something that we feel truly embodies the message that we're trying to portray here. And we look forward to sharing some of the deeper meanings behind it through our videos in the future. So please come along with us on this journey in this new chapter of our vlog.
Join our extra family, hit that subscribe button.
And help us let everyone know about this exciting new change by sharing our content.
Go check out all of our other social media. We'll be switching our names there as well.
And get excited about all the brand new extra fam videos coming your way.
All right, guys, we'll see you in the next video.
Bye, guys. Bye.